Hey, what's up everyone? TJ here. In this video, I'm gonna highlight four more entry-level snowboards that are gonna be a good choice to look at if you're just getting into snowboarding. Maybe it's your first season out on snow, and are just gonna make that progression a little bit easier for you as you're out there learning the fundamentals of riding. Let's get into it. All right, all these boards are gonna have a few things in common. They're all gonna be true twins, so they're gonna feel the same whether you're riding your regular or your switch stance. They're all gonna have a mellower flex, so they'll be easier to control. And they're all gonna have camber profiles that'll help lower the chances of you catching your edge as you're out there figuring things out. And the first board I wanna highlight is the Roam Gangplank. This is actually gonna be the most expensive board on this list, coming in right at $450. But I still think it's a good one to consider, and it has some good tech built into it to help justify that price. The Gangplank runs a flat to rocker profile, which is gonna offer a nice predictable feel that's easy to control, while those rocker tips are gonna help make the board less catchy and also give you more leverage for leaning into presses if that's something you're interested in doing. You're also gonna find some other tech in this board, like their bamboo hot rods in the nose and tail to help give those rocker tips a little bit more energy and pop for ollies if you're trying to learn more freestyle stuff with this board, as well as Roam's impact plates underfoot. So some added fiberglass underfoot to help dampen things out for you as you're out there exploring on the mountain, as well as an extruded base. An extruded base is gonna offer you two main benefits. One is less maintenance. You're not gonna have to worry about waxing the board as often. And it's also gonna be easier to repair. So if you end up scratching the base on a rock, or as you're out there maybe learning to hit boxes and rails, you're gonna be able to get a more durable repair at home without having to worry about taking the board to a shop. Overall, the Gangplank is a very playful and buttery snowboard. It's easy to control and definitely a great choice for learning the fundamentals as well as freestyle progression. The next board I wanna highlight is the Battalion Blow. This is gonna be the entry-level snowboard from Battalion, but you're still gonna get their staples, which is a full positive camber profile combined with their triple base technology. And it runs a very mellow camber, so you're still gonna get that more energetic, positive camber feel, but it's not very aggressive. You're also gonna find the mellowest version of their 3D base shape, so you still have a pretty wide platform to balance on as you're out there riding, or if you're leaning into presses and butters, it's gonna be a little bit easier to find that balance point, but you're still gonna get the benefits of those lifted contact points, which I think the main one is that it makes the board very catch-free. You're also gonna find Battalion's shock walls, which is basically just a urethane-infused sidewall to help give the board a little bit more dampening, as well as an extruded base. So, overall, the Blow, like pretty much all the boards on this list, is a softer flexing snowboard. It's playful, it's buttery, it's easy to control, but you get the added benefit of that full positive camber profile, so it's gonna offer a little bit more pop and energy compared to boards with rocker in the profile. Gonna be a great choice to learn on, and it comes in right around $400. The next board I wanna highlight is the Nitro Cheap Thrills. This one also comes in right around $400. It runs a flat to rocker camber profile, so similar to the Gangplank, gonna offer a very predictable feel. That rocker helps to make it catch free, also gives you more leverage for presses, but this board does have some cool tech built into it. You're gonna find urethane sidewalls, which is gonna help dampen out vibrations as you're out there riding and exploring the mountain, as well as Nitro's rail killer edges. So some more durable metal edges built into this board. I believe they're about twice as thick as your typical metal edge. That'll help add some durability if you're trying to learn to hit rails and boxes in the park. And it also runs an extruded base. Overall, this is gonna be a pretty soft flexing snowboard. It's actually the softest board on the Nitro lineup, so it's gonna make it easier for you out there learning the fundamentals and gonna be a good choice for freestyle progression as well. All right, and the fourth board I wanna highlight is the Reverse Camber Capita Pathfinder. This board replaced the Horoscope on the Capita lineup this year, and similar to the Roam and the Nitro, it also runs a flat to rocker profile, so you're gonna get that predictable feel, you're gonna get more leverage for presses. It's a jibby, buttery, easy to control snowboard, and it comes in right around $420. One thing a little unique about this board is that it runs a more blunted shape, so that means that the nose and tail outside the contact points is a little bit shorter, so you get more effective edge at a smaller size, so you might get a little more stability, a little bit more control out of this one compared to other boards at the same size. You're also gonna get all the benefits we talked about earlier from an extruded base, and it comes in a ton of sizes. You can get this board all the way down to a 145. This is actually one of my personal favorites I was able to test over the last season. Really fun, more jib-leaning park board. Definitely gonna be helpful for you out there learning the fundamentals, but also a good choice to grow into with freestyle progression if you're trying to learn those more pressed out, more technical tricks. This one's gonna come through for you for that type of riding as well. And one more board I wanna briefly mention is the Yes Basic. I haven't ridden this board in a few seasons, but there haven't been any major changes to it. And something unique about this one is that it runs a Camrock camber profile, so camber between the feet, rocker in the tips. So you get a little bit more energy out of it, but you still get those benefits of the rocker tips, as well as Yes's underbite tech. So you get added contact points underfoot to help give you more grip on icy snow. And it also runs an extruded base. It's one of my personal favorite beginner choices. So even though I haven't ridden it in a while, I thought it was worth mentioning. All right, guys, so those are the boards I wanted to highlight for this year's beginner picks. I hope you got some value out of this video and that it helps you out as you're out there looking for your new snowboard. If you've ridden any of these boards, let us know what you thought about them down in the comments. Make sure to drop a like on the video, subscribe for more reviews. I appreciate you guys. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in a new one soon. Later, guys.